horrific criminal terrorist attack upon a synagogue last Shabbat leaves many of us wondering, in these troubling times, where can we find security? Where is our safe place? If houses of God, transcending all the Abrahamic faiths, Judaism, Christianity, and Islam around the globe, are targets, where can we go to find safety and security? Judaism provides us with the direction to take. We find it in our prayers. As you know, on Friday evening, we offer the Hashkivenu prayer. We pray to God that we lie down in peace and that we wake up in peace, that God protects us. It's not, in my opinion, a matter of accident that Hashkivenu is offered in the evening, at night. So what occurs at night? The lights are off. We find ourselves in a room, in an atmosphere of darkness. In this atmosphere of darkness, we ask God to create for us a sukkah shalom, a sukkah of peace. Now, bringing the two together makes perfect sense. Sukkah is a vulnerable structure, opening up to the winds of change. Live in a sukkah. If you are amongst those who spend the week of Sukkot in a sukkah, and it rains, what happens? You get wet. If a strong wind blows through, you feel a chill. As a matter of fact, the sukkah could even be poured down. But even in these times, where we get the feeling that we're living in a sukkah open to the elements, we reach out to God as our protector, as our shield. And how does God protect us? There are many ways. With giving us courage to meet each and every new day, to go forward and live our lives to the fullest. God gives us a direction to meet the challenges and the insecurities, not simply to accept what is, but where there is darkness, bring our light of love. We need not accept the status quo. Where else do we find security? Within the family. The family is and should be the one place where we could find love and security, caring, help, and shelter from life's storms. Many years ago, I was invited to a meeting with the Dalai Lama, a number of rabbis, and he turned to us and said, Tibet, we are under the yoke of the Chinese. We're not doing too well. Our survivorship is a great peril. And yet you, the Jewish people, in spite of all that you have gone through, all the turmoil, all all the hate you've encountered, you are strong and resilient. Where do you find the strength? What is the secret to your survival? In spite of everything your life brings your way. And one rabbi stood up with his wife and he said, we are a family. In the family, we are there for one another. In the family, we teach values of helping others. In the family, we teach our history. We realize within our history and being bound one to the other is the hope for today and for tomorrow. Yes, our security lies in our families. But not only our nuclear families, not only the bond between couples and the children, but even larger families. Our Temple Israel is truly a temple family. It's a sacred space. We have the opportunity to express our appreciation, love not only for the Holy One of the Universe, but for each other and to each other. We have a tremendous family that's international. It's called the Jewish people. The Jewish people that have gone forward not only to secure our traditions and our lives, but make the world a better place. And so, dear friends, so my family members, in these times that are troubling, to say the least, in these times when we look for shelter from life's storms, let us turn to God with a sense of security and hope. Let us turn one to the other, and then together go from strength to strength, bringing light to a world filled with darkness. Shabbat Shalom.